that we spat that whole song out in like 3 hours. And that was probably like my most favorite song that I've recorded thus far. Well, not my favorite, but one of my favorites, because it was just such a great process. Like the way we were sitting there, we were like, oh, let's say this, let's say that. That's why if you listen to Mess It Up, like it's just a fun record. Like it's just having fun. Like it's no real storyline to it. Like it's not like any of my other records where it's like a storyline. Like Mama Told Me is like what my mother told me. Toxic is like talking about a toxic situation. Like Mess It Up is just like me having fun. Like literally the whole track is just a bunch of fun. And that's really it, yeah.
And it's new, okay, it's a vibe.
Yeah.
So, and then that was just my serendipitous question. My real question is, you've been dancing for 17 years and rapping for the last two. Tell me about that, and what are your favorite performances as a dancer?
Dancing has just been my whole life, obviously. I'm 19 years old and I've been dancing for 17 years. So that should tell you how much I've been dancing in my whole lifetime. I used to be a competition dancer. So I would have to say that like when we went to like nationals and stuff like that, that was my favorite of all. We went on like a cruise ship and we were all together on a cruise ship. You know, they had like teen clubs and stuff. So I just thought it was like the best thing ever whenever I would go to nationals and stuff.
Do you know that dance show that comes or came on MTV? I can't remember the name of it. Was it something like that? I can't remember. God, it was just a dance show that came on.
It was on MTV? Was...
I'm sorry?
It was on MTV or Fox?
It was on one of them. It was black. It's black people though.
Was it the Dancing Dolls? The Bring
It? Dancing Dolls, yes. So it was something like what you did was something compared to that?
Yeah, something compared to that, but a more technical, like more on a technical aspect. Uh-huh. A lot of people do come, like every time I tell somebody I can dance, they're like the Dancing Dolls? I'm like...
like an insult?
I'm like, is that all you know about dance? But I can't blame them if that's all that's being, you know, portrayed on TV. But...
Thanks.
I can do what they do, but I prefer to do technical stuff.
So you, when I saw your videos or your Instagram page, you had ballet, like it was just a wide range of dance moves. So like, how long did it take you to learn how to do that?
I feel like dance is such like, it's a learning sport. Mm-hmm. And it's like, you learn by, of course, like learning, retaining the choreo and stuff, but it's such like, You have to watch so many people to like understand and interpret a way of your own movement.
Right.
Because it's so hard to develop your own movement. You're always trying to be like somebody else. You're trying to be like the girl you're competing against. You're trying to be like, you know, the girl next to you in your studio. It's so hard to like interpret your own kind of way of movement. Okay. And I think that took me, I tell people that I didn't get serious about it until probably my 6th, 7th grade year. Mm-hmm. And I was like, okay, like this is what I really want to do. And I started like, you know, my mom started putting me in more classes that were just at her dance studio. She started putting me at other dance classes, other places. And that's when I really started to like take it seriously and just become, you know, my own kind of dancer.
When did you take rapping seriously?
I started taking rapping seriously 2 years ago. I was, I love telling this story. This is my favorite story to tell. I was watching I can't remember what award show it was. I'm gonna have to go look it up. It was Cardi B, and she was doing press. It was like when press just came out, so she was performing it like everywhere. And I was watching her do it. I can't remember what award show it was, but she was doing it at some award show. Me and my mom were watching it. Like that's something me and my mom do. If it's like an award show, we sit in her room and we like have popcorn and we're watching an award show. But I was watching it, and I was like, this is what I want to do. And she was like, huh? I was like, I want to do this. I was like, I want to be an artist. Like, I want to have somebody that writes the lyrics for me. And all I have to do is like go into the studio and rap it. I'm thinking like it's so easy at this point. I'm like, all I have to do is go into the studio and rap it and all this other stuff. And she was like, my mom's the kind of like the kind of mom that like, if I tell her I want to go do something, she's gonna make it happen. Like, yeah, she goes full on support mode. Like she doesn't hold back. She's not like, oh girl, you don't want to do that for real. Like she's like, okay, let's do it. And that's exactly how she was. Like she called a few people because my mom used to be in the industry. So she called a few people that she knew and she was like, hey, Rosie wants to be an artist. Like, what are we doing? And that's, I met Abe And, you know, I tell everybody I met him in the basement of a restaurant and I sang for him because that's literally how it was. He owned, Mr. Abe owns a restaurant called Ponko Chicken. Mm-hmm. And he owns that restaurant. And I went down there and I was just like, I sang Rise Up by like Sandra Day or something like that. Uh-huh. And he, you know, he took me from there and he was like, okay, we're doing this. We're making you into an artist. And then later on is when, you know, I started coming out with music. My mom's like, okay, we have to shoot videos. So we shoot videos. And then like ever since recently, when we started talking to C-No and Tanji and CJ, we formed like this team and we've just been pushing me as an artist. I want to say I've been taking it serious since I've been recording the songs, but I've been like really pushing it and going hard for it since like the whole team has gotten together. Like we've really been doing a lot in these past couple of months. Yeah.
Once you realize there was more into involved with it, you know, the artistry is not just like you said, you were sounding like the City Girls. And not to say that they sound bad. They have that Miami sound going on, but I can't jive with that. That's just not my flavor. Like I like hardcore rap. So I'm glad that you pointed it out. Like you got to feel it. You got to do this and you got to do that because it is a lot more than just rhyming. So therefore you took it serious at the moment. You knew, okay, nah, I got to go harder. So big ups to you for that. So I'm sure that you have extraordinary stage presence when you dance. But getting on the mic and spitting rhymes while dancing, that's different. Was that transition difficult?
Yes, it's difficult because I was also a theater kid. So I did a lot of like plays and stuff like that. So as far as like being on the mic talking, I'm cool. I can talk to people on the mic all day long. But when you're rapping, like I just had a listening party like a month ago. Mm-hmm. And I tell you, I was so nervous. It's just so much going into your mind. Like when you're singing other people's songs, you know people love that song already. Right. But now you're singing like your own song. People don't know who you are. You don't want to get booed. Like, oh my goodness, I could not imagine rapping. And they're like, get off the stage, you suck. I'd be like, I would start crying. So I don't know. I think it's been a challenge. I have a performance coming up on the 4th of September and probably some before that, but I'm nervous because I'm just like, it's so hard because it's hard performing for a crowd because you know, like when you're like, put your hands up and everybody's like,
looking crazy.
So it's just nerve wracking and I'm still trying to get over those nerves. But if you tell me to go on that stage and dance, I'll dance all day. But
okay,
I'd be like, ooh, okay, y'all, we gonna work.
Then you turn it up on stage. Then that's my other question. Like, your mom was a WWE wrestler, correct?
My uncle.
Your uncle. Okay, so you grew up surrounded by successful people in your family. Do you think that there, and not just your uncle, but just a lot of people were very successful. Do you think there was pressure there to be great, to be grow, become more than average?
I think the pressure comes from within. It never came from my mom. I tell people all the time, my mom didn't want me to be a dancer. She wanted to be a soccer player. Mm-hmm. Like, she wanted to be a soccer mom. She wanted to take me to soccer practice. She did not want me to dance because she didn't want to feel like people were going to say, kind of like what they say now, like, oh, you're dancing because your mom owns a studio. Like, you know, like I truly fell in love with dance at a young age and I wanted to do it. Like, I fell in love with dance. I fell in love with my friends that were here. Like, it was just such a cool thing. And then as far as my uncle goes, I never think it's bad for anybody to want you to be great.
Right.
And he wanted me to be great. And same as for his son, like, he wanted us to be great. He just wanted us to always do what we had to do, make sure we, you know, we look good. And he's like, you know, whatever you got to do, Taylor, like, if you're going to be a dancer, he always told me, he was like, if you're going to be a dancer, you need to be a damn good dancer. He will always tell me that. He was like, you need to be good at what you do. And I don't think that was like hard love or forcing me to be great or anything like that. That was just like real stuff. And it's what I needed to hear. And that's how I am the way I am today.
You were inspired.
Yes, inspired more than pushed or forced to be the way that I am.
I love it. So are you introvert or extrovert or both?
Oh, kind of both. I do enjoy hanging out with my friends, But I tell them all the time, I'd be like, y'all, my social battery's going down. I'm going home. Like, I have to drive myself everywhere. I refuse to like drive in the car with other people because if I want to leave, I want to leave. Okay. Like, I don't want anybody else to be like, oh, but I'm enjoying myself. Are you sure you want to leave? So yeah, I'd be like, I'm gonna just meet y'all there. So I'm kind of both, cause I love to party. If you see me in a party setting, you're gonna be like, you're no introvert, but my battery will go low real quick. I can hear you.
Mm-mm. Can you now?
Yeah.
Okay, who is your celebrity crush?
Oh! I have a couple. Michael B. Jordan was my celebrity crush for like the longest, but I mean, yes. Like, why not? Why not? I would say Michael B. Jordan. I used to have a crush on Young and May. I used to have a crush on her, yes. I used to think she was so cute. I'm like, oh, I have a crush. But definitely Michael B. Jordan he stays my crush all the time. When I was really young, I used to have a crush on Mylan's Behavior. You know Rock Royal from Mylan's Behavior? He was the quieter. He had like an app. He had a puffball in the back and he always wore like the hat. Yeah, he was my favorite. It went on mute again. It went on mute.
Dang, T Blaine, I gotta do better. Okay. Who would you like to perform with?
Oh. There's so many people. I love Doja Cat. I love Doja Cat. I'm not sure. I feel like no matter what track she's on, like, she's herself. So I'm a heavy Doja Cat stan. I love Bia. I love Bia right now. My brother is actually the choreographer for her. And he's a dancer for her as well.
That's awesome.
So I'm like, get me in there. But yeah, Bia for sure. And then there's a new artist. Her name's like Lakia. I love her too.
Lakia, is she a rapper? She's a rapper?
She's a rapper, yeah.
Okay, all right. So as far as your songs, because we're gonna go back into that because the record, that whole thing was just so whack at the beginning.
Yeah.
Okay. I think you can give out good information. Great content, just wasn't rolling, wasn't recording, okay?
Yeah. So
tell me about your latest single, Toxic and Mama Told Me. And then what was one of the lessons that your mama told you that stuck with you and served you till this day?
Okay, so Toxic is not out yet, but Mess It Up is out and Mama Told Me is out.
Okay.
As you know, like I was saying before, Mess It Up was such like, it was one of my favorite processes of like recording a song. Mm-hmm. It was so quick. It was written in 3 hours and we just said it. We did everything real fast. It's really just like a fun track that's just like party, literally. I felt like I was in like a club. I've never been to a club, so I didn't want to say that. But but yeah, it felt like, you know, what a club would feel like to me. So yeah.
Adult vibe. Okay.
Yes, adult vibe. And Mama Told Me, that was my first ever song. So I re-recorded that song so many times. I re-recorded it so much. But it was just because I wanted to get it right and I wanted it to sound like the artist that I was forming into when I recorded a later song like Mess It Up.
Right.
So yeah. And one lesson that my mother told me, she taught me a lot of things. Let me see, something that I didn't say in the song, a lesson that my mom taught me. If you want anything, you have to be consistent. I think I still say that over and over in my head because it's so hard. It's not hard to be consistent, but it's hard to be consistent in a lot of things. So consistency is something that my mom told me and taught me that I'm still working on today.
Okay, I love it. So you're still utilizing those good, warm, let's see, golden nuggets.
Yeah, she's still dropping them too. She's still dropping them.
Somebody looking around like, yeah, she is. Yeah, she's still dropping them. But so with TikTok, can we expect a new dance to go with your song?
There's a dance. I did it today. I went on live today and they were like, yeah, we need a dance. We're going to do it. So I dropped the dance today. It's just called the Mess It Up Challenge. It is on my TikTok. It's just @IamRosie_, and it's on my Instagram, @IamRosie_. And as long as anybody tags me or does #MessItUpChallenge, I will see it.
Okay. Okay, I can dig it. So makeup and hair is how you originally got on TikTok. Is that something you do?
No. That's why I got on TikTok, because I was like, you know, at first I was just making silly videos on TikTok, but I recently have started doing my makeup and hair on TikTok because I don't know how to do my makeup and hair. Like, that's why I have people like my sister Casey and my sister Darisha that do my makeup and hair for every event, because if it was left up to me,
it'd be wild.
It would just be crazy. I did my hair today, so this is kind of cute,
girl.
This is kind of cute.
Yes. But
some days I don't make it.
Somebody like, I be struggling, okay?
Yes. So, yes, I started a little series on my TikTok. Just, you know, I think it's kind of funny when I do my makeup and hair, and so do other people. So I'm like, yeah, go ahead and watch it. And then I'll be watching myself do it, and I'll just want to see the progress from like now until like next year. See if I can like finally do a wing. I still don't know how to.
Okay. Oh, them lashes gonna be popping by next year. Just yes. Keep it up, okay?
That is the plan. Yes.
So, take rapping and dancing out of the equation. What are your strengths and weaknesses?
A weakness for me is consistency.
Consistency.
Okay. It's a weakness for me. A strength for me is leadership. No matter where you put me, I say this all the time, I try to get regular jobs so much. Like, I try to work at like a Amazon or like a Chick-fil-A. And leadership is always a strong suit of mine. I'm never somebody that sits back, and I'm never like, oh, like, I guess I'll just wait. I guess I'll just see what happens. Like, I'm like, no, is something wrong? Like, let's fix it. Let's fix it now.
Right.
So, I want to say leadership is one of my
strong qualities. Okay. Now, favorite affirmation that you read over and over again?
I do affirmations every morning with my mom.
Oh.
We do this whole video. Hard. Dang, I never get stumped by a question. This is good. Okay, let me think. I'm gonna do a simple one because I do love this one a lot. You are what you get what you attract, or like, what is it? Whatever you put in is what you attract. Mm-hmm. Whatever you put in is what you get out.
Right.
I say that a lot to myself. Yeah, I'm just gonna keep it at that one, because a lot of them, they just get really deep for me, and I'm still working on those right now. But yeah.
Self-motivation. I love it.
Yes, okay. Self-motivation is important to me.
Awesome. So what next for you?
What isn't next for me? I don't want to put myself in a box, and I don't want to speak it out and limit myself. I just want to say there's so many things that are coming up for me. There's collabs that are coming up. There's features. There's performances, tours, all that cool kind of stuff. Yes, that we do have in the works, so I'm excited. New music, for sure.
New music. So Mess It Up for now, and Mama Told Me.
Yes.
Okay. All right. And then what's the name? Is it an EP?
The EP?
Yes.
We haven't dropped the EP yet.
Okay. No. So it's just singles.
Yes. Singles that we're dropping right now.
Okay. All right. So do you envision movie scores? Like, what else is good, or you can't
see? Yes. Oh, yes. I do see movies. I act a lot. I do have a movie that I'm supposed to be filming soon.
Wow.
And movies, plays, anything. I'm just so down for it all.
Oh, I'm happy for you. Woo woo. Okay, Queen Vibes. So then my last question, where can our viewers follow you and download your music?
You can follow me on Instagram at @IamRosie_. You can follow me on TikTok at @IamRosie_. You can follow me on Twitter, even though I don't know how to work it yet. You can follow me on Twitter at @IamRosie_. And you can follow me on Snapchat. This one is a little different. It's Rosie 725001.
Okay, I love it. And Twitter, like, I go to Twitter sometimes, but Instagram has just kind of taken over. So that's where it's at.
Literally, I know everybody's like, you should get on Twitter. I'm like, okay. Oh, and you can stream all my music on all streaming platforms, unless there's like one that I don't know about. But all streaming platforms, and you can find me at t.rosie on anything, Spotify, Apple, anything.
I do have one last question, because when I went to Google you to research you, I did see a lot of T. Rosie. So the t.rosie is what sets you aside from everyone else?
Yes, t.rosie. There's like, first we were like, just gonna be like Rosie, but then there were so many like other Rosies, and I was like, let's just go with T.Rosie. And just T.Rosie, I feel like it's too plain, but like T.Rosie. So, you know, one of the people on my team, Cino, he loves to say that. He's like, T.Rosie. He calls me T.Dot. That's his nickname for me.
Well, so they want to get stern. That's when you know they get stern, because they're going to emphasize the dots.
Yeah, he's like, T.Dot. Like, uh-oh.
You done it now. So thank you so much. I had a great time, even with the dogs cutting up. And I appreciate you for taking the time out, and just keep shining and keep vibing.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely.
Have a great night. Bye.